this is part of justice for us. It's not the whole thing yet, but it's a good start.
Two Russians and a pro-Russian Ukrainian tried in their absence, found guilty of shooting down flight MH17.
Suspects Gherkin, Dubinsky and Karchenko are convicted for co-perpetration of multiple counts of murder.
The Dutch court holding Moscow directly responsible for the Russian missile, which killed 298 people, including 38 Australians in 2014.
That these people could decide to down a civilian aircraft.
Sorry.
Hang on, just take with children on it? It's beyond words.
8 years of international investigations culminating in this criminal trial. Victims' families travelling from around the world to hear the verdict.
It doesn't take away any of the grief or sadness that we have, but that's not what today was about.
We've seen some justice today. It's only a small amount, but you know, it's important that we establish what happened.
The $29 million fine, though, will likely go unpaid, the three life sentences unserved. Russian authorities denying responsibility and refusing to hand over the trio.
We call upon Russia to hand over for justice the people who are involved in this and who've been found to be guilty in absentia.
Closure continuing to elude those left devastated by the tragedy.
It's a real difficult thing going through your life each day, wondering why this happened and what would lead people to do this.
It would be complete justice if our family members were restored to us.
And Paul Gard, who lost his parents Roger and Jill when MH17 was down, joins us now from Amsterdam. Paul, your family has been following this trial closely. You were at court. How did you feel when the sentence was handed down?
Yes, it was an emotional day for the families. It has been a long road getting to this point, and we were pleased to see that the court presented a very methodical and thorough summary of its findings, and that in this case they found a guilty verdict.
Paul, given it seems that no one will serve time behind bars for this heinous crime, do you think justice has been served here?
It is difficult to know what true justice would be in a case like this. Obviously, we'd just like our loved ones back, but that's not possible. However, I think it's the important thing the trial has achieved is showing the world exactly what happened, showing the weight of evidence that exists. And also just providing, hopefully, a disincentive for people who might think about getting involved in these sorts of things, even if they can't be apprehended. There is some chance, I suppose, one or two of them or three might be apprehended in the war if they are fighting in Ukraine. I believe one of them may be. So in any case, I think it is important that the facts were laid out in a court.
Paul, your parents, Roger and Jill, were adventurers. They were avid travellers. Is that how you will carry on their memory?
Yes, our parents were wonderful people. They gave us a lot of opportunities as kids travelling and also enjoying time in nature. So we're continuing in that tradition and we do miss them every day, and we wish that they could be here with us. But in their absence, we're honouring their memory by continuing to do many of the same things we did with them. So, yes.
They will be remembered, Paul. Thank you very much for your time tonight. We appreciate it.
Thank you very much.